Razorbacks have momentum, gaining ground on SEC West heavyweights.
Boy, Houdini's in the house. Player number three. Touchdown, holy hog!
After an offseason filled with turmoil, a head coach dismissed, the program stands at a crossroad. Can the Hogs weather the storm? The time to dig deep is now on the road to the BCS Championship.
A team from the SEC has won the BCS championship for six straight years, here with a pair of players that have hopes their team can make it seven in a row. Arkansas quarterback Tyler Wilson, running back Nile Davis, joining us on SportsCenter. And your team had to deal with unexpected change this offseason with the departure of your head coach, Bobby Petrino. He recently reached out to you. What did he say?
I think there were some well wishes. Obviously, it wasn't the greatest situation for a university, but I think there was some remorse there, and I think he spoke to Nile and I both, and wished us well, and we're anxious moving forward.
The way that unfolded was extremely unexpected. What did you take away from your conversation with him?
Well, I mean, he's just very humble, just wishing us well. I really needed that, and it was good to hear from him. But, just moving forward, we just want to have an awesome season this year. And that's where our focus is right now.
Let's talk about moving forward, because Petrino's replacement, John L. Smith, made quite the impression at SEC Media Day. Let's take a look.
Our mental capacity, what was the first part of that question again? Do I look stupid? I know I probably don't answer that.
Was contact between you and Arkansas initiated before Petrino was officially dismissed or after? How was it initiated? And also, have you had any conversation or conversations with him about the football team?
Could we move on to the next question, at least one with intelligence? We're a big believer that we have to do everything that we can do to get the players in the state of Arkansas to stay in Arkansas. We love Little Rock. To me, it's an automatic. Not gonna take advantage. Don't be a gosh what if guy. Don't be that guy. Don't ever look back. Don't take anything for granted. Because if they want you out the door, you're gonna be out the door regardless of who you are. That's why that 10-month contract doesn't really bother me. We're gonna knock on wood and make things happen to where we give him no choice but to say, yeah, you're gonna be back here next year.
Very animated. What is it like having him as your head coach?
John Nell is a great guy, has a great personality. He has a big heart, and I love to play for him. And a lot of people on the outside looking in kind of see him as he likes to play around, joke around. But John Nell has a serious side. When it's time for business, when it's time for practice, when it's time to strap the helmet on, it's no games. We're a very serious group, and I think we would be very well prepared.
Let's get down to business. 11-2 last season. Your only losses to LSU and Alabama. Both those teams ended up playing for the national championship. What are your expectations, given what you did last year, moving forward?
Well, the expectations are high in our camp, for sure. I think I've made sure that the rest of the guys know that. There's no changing goals here at Arkansas. And we've got both those teams at home. To get over the hump, we got to beat those two teams, and I think everybody knows that. And so we're going to continue to do what we do, prepare, work hard, and maybe surprise people come September.
You were coming off an injury. You didn't get to play last season because of an ankle injury, which I know has to be incredibly frustrating. How's that ankle doing now?
It's doing good. I have all, my strength back, power back. Did great testing in the off season. I have one more hurdle to, kind of jump over, is go through camp and try to get, my first contact, which I'm ready for. I'm just anxious, excited to get ready.
Before we let you go, looking at the time that you arrived on campus in 2008, that team was 5-7. Then you go 8-5. Then you go 10-3. Then you go 11-2. I mean, that's a steep improvement there. Right. How's the culture changed just in the time that you've been there?
Well, I think everybody's bought in. I think that's probably the biggest difference, is you see the atmosphere, the attitude, whatever you want to call it, the locker room is completely changed and they're bought in. And that's why I think we'll be very successful, is because that attitude, that atmosphere hasn't changed. We're continuing to do the same things in the off season. The schedule is going to remain the same. during the season. So with that attitude, with that preparation mindset, I think we can be very, very, very successful.
Anyone want to do a pig suing before we sign off here?
I'll do it. Oh!
Pig suey. I thought I was going to have to twist some arms. I'm impressed. Arkansas opens the season against Jacksonville State September 1st. Tyler Wilson, Niall Davis doing the pig suey here. Best of luck this season.
Thank you.